all the kind of events that have happened in our life, somewhere or other, these events had impact in our life and it has got. Hello everyone, today we'll be talking about one of the aspects of social psychology, which talks about personality, that is how a person gains a personality, how the person is thinking, how the person is acting and how the person behaves. Now if you see in the real world, what we find is that each and every individual possesses a certain kind of personality. Now where is this person learning all this, and how come the personality varies from person to person? So a major role of psychology explains about this, that how come we have people of different personalities and what are the theories that impact the personality of a person. So what is a personality? Now if I talk about what is a personality, so personality is how a person thinks, how a person acts, or I should say how a person behaves, and how a person is able to control themselves. So today we'll be talking about that, what are the theories that actually talk about personality. That means whatever we people have, like whatever personality we people possess, what are the factors that contributes towards that personality development. So moving ahead, this is the theories of personality. Now what are the theories of personality? First one is psychodynamic, the other one is behaviorist, third one is humanist, and the fourth one is trait. Now if we focus on the psychodynamic perspective, since the video is a short video, hence we'll be just talking about the key point, whereas the detailed part of psychodynamic talks about how the unconscious mind etc. is talking about. Now the psychodynamic perspective focuses on the working of unconscious mind. That means all the kind of events that have happened in our life, somewhere or other, these events had impact in our life and it has got stored, or the events or the information has got stored in our unconscious mind. Now how is this unconscious mind operating? How the unconscious mind influences our behavior? How we are able to interpret the information that is stored in an unconscious mind? So psychodynamic perspective talks about this. Now coming to the behaviorist approach. So behaviorist approach talks about that the personality is all about learning. That means in the process, whatever we have learned from the experiences, from the events of the life, so our personality is nothing but whatever we have learned, that is how we display. So behaviorist approach, or you can say the behaviorist theorist, basically talk about learning. That means whatever we have learned. For example, a person, people might have told a person that you are very short-tempered. So the person has learned it in the process that, it is because I have this thing of reacting, and that is probably the reason why I am a short-tempered person. So this is the entire processes of learning. So behaviorist theorists talk about that your personality is basically dependent on what behavior, and behavior is what which you learn in the process. Now the third one is humanistic perspective. Now what is humanistic perspective? Now the humanistic perspective talks about that this theory is majorly focusing on the life experiences. I mean, what are your life experiences? And what is the environment in which the person has been raised? Now, talking about the trait theory. Now, this theory focuses on the characteristics of the personality. They are not focusing on the unconscious mind, on the learning capacity, on the environment, etc. They directly focus on the trait of the person's personality. So, trait theorists are focusing on the characteristics of the personality. Fine. So all in all, these theories are explained in detail, but here we will be covering in short, short points that what signifies what. So in psychodynamic, it's about unconscious mind. Then behaviorist is talking about learning in the process, what you have learned. Then humanistic perspective talks about your life experiences and the environment in which you have been living. Trait is talking about the characteristics of a personality. Now, I'll be taking one of the approach and we'll be talking about that. That is the behaviorist approach. So, I'll be talking about the behaviorist approach or the social cognitive view, how this actually influences the personality. Now, behavioral and social cognitive view. Now, how behavior or the theorist of behaviorism are talking about personality, that means how your behavior influences your personality and how the social cognitive view actually transforms your personality. So, social cognitive view and behaviorist view. Now, these theorists, that means the behaviorist theorists, what do they believe in? Now, they said that the personality of the person depends upon the learning aspect. That means whatever you have learned all through your life, that is how a person behaves. So, how is this happening? Now, understand that in behaviorist approach, they majorly focus on the learning of the person which happens because of conditioning. Now, what is that conditioning? So, which happens because of conditioning. And conditioning is done through two ways. One is classical conditioning. And other one is operant conditioning. This you shall study in detail in the classes. However, how conditioning is taking place, it is because of classical conditioning and operant conditioning. Now, if I talk about social cognitive view, now how is social cognitive view contributing towards personality? So, just understand that whatever you are learning from the environment you are in, that means in social cognitive view, it's majorly about the environment you are staying in. The environment you stay in. Now, how does the environment influence the behavior of the person, or what does the person learn in the process? So, in environment, what you find is that there are two experiments that have been conducted. One is the Bandura experiment, very famous experiment. And the other one is Rotter's experiment. Now, I shall, just tell you in short what is this Bandura and Rotter experiment. Now, Bandura experiment, it is actually talking about the self-efficacy whereas the Rotter's experiment has talked about the person's personality always depends upon the potential of the person. Potential of the person to actually take on the challenges of the life. That means the challenges or the potential of the person to deal with those challenges. Right? Now, this was with respect to behavioral and social cognitive view. The other one that I have taken is humanistic view. That means what is the humanistic perspective about the personality of the person. So the humanistic view also has various types. For example, this humanistic view majorly talks about Carl Rogers' perspective and Maslow's perspective. Now, what was Roger and Maslow's perspective? So, the Rogers perspective, the Maslow's perspective. Now, Rogers perspective and a humanistic perspective, the Rogers perspective talks about what the individuals are always trying to thrive or to strive to the best of their capabilities. So Rogers' perspective is also always talking about what humans are always striving to fulfill to the best of their capabilities, right? So this is actually talking about the capability of the person. Then we have Maslow's theory, which talks about self-actualization. Now, what is self-actualization? So just understand what happens is that under self-actualization, you have the hierarchy. Now, hierarchy as in what? For example, we first have to go for our physiological needs, then we go for, employment, then we go for love, affection, relationships. Now, in this way, what is happening is that the person is striving for all the best things in the life. That means the person is capable of doing all of the best things. So that is how the person develops a personality. That means the person first tries to, get a hold on having an occupation, then having a good relationship. So that way, the personality of a person evolves. Now, self-actualization, Rogers' capabilities theory. Now, the next one is, you can also understand that in a layman term, that means a real self and ideal self. That means what happens is that there is always an ideal self. That means a person thinks that, the best thing a person can do is this. However, the person right now is somewhere, not up to the best of his potential. So there is an ideal self and there is a real self. So there is always a difference between an ideal and a real self. Now what is happening is that a person has an ideal self and a person has a real self. That means a real self is a person that a person know, and then ideal self is that a person has an expectation that I can be this kind of person. So when the ideal self and real self are in conflict, that means they are like opposite of a personality trait. What happens is then from there onwards, the person have these issues of anxiety, stress and disorders. Why? Because they are not able to align the ideal self with the real self. However, if the person is working towards the real self and the person has this ideal self scenario in front of them, so what happens is that this get incongruent to each other, and that is when the goal of having the best personality or having the good personality is fulfilled. So that was about ideal self and real self, self-actualization, Rogers' theory. Now, there's a lot to be discussed with respect to personality. This is just the glimpse of how the environment and how our how do we learn in the process, how the events transform us. Though we know it in a layman language, but when it comes to psychology, we have to explain it in the answer sheets. That means what theory talks about what, and how can we actually change our personality. That means if a person is very pessimist, and how can a person turn into an optimistic person, because all this is a process of learning. So if you can learn to be a pessimist, then definitely you can learn to be an optimistic person as well. So this is how a personality of a person can be transformed, and how this is working. So this was about what is personality. That means a person, how a person thinks, acts, behave, how a person control themselves. That is the personality of a person. Then what are the theories of the personality? There is one psychodynamic perspective, which again talks about the unconscious mind. That means what role unconscious mind plays. Then behaviorist approach talks about how a person learns things in the process, and that is what is the reflection of a person's personality. Humanistic perspective talks about life experiences and the environment in which the person is thriving. Trait directly talks about the characteristics of the personality. They are not talking about the environment, etc. However, I have taken the two aspects, that means the behavioral and the humanistic approach, which majorly are focusing on the place where the person is planted. Thank you so much.